I don't even play the game no more. And I ain't gonna lie to you, I listened to my boy E. You know what I'm saying? Shout out to E. The man was like, bro, you know it's like 300 some people that's trying to do what you do. What is you doing on the game? I was like, you right, E. You know what I'm saying? Like, I gotta take things to the, I gotta take things to the next level. You know what I'm saying? And the next level is my mindset, you know, my habits, you know, things that I do. Again, like behind closed doors, like those taking things to my relationship, like that's taking things to the next level, you know, and especially in our business, like that's what's gonna add on to that next level. So, man, yeah, bro, that's what I had to do. I cut the game, I don't even play the game no more.
Dang,
you know what I'm saying? I'll tell you, I barely even listen to rap. If I listen to rap, I don't even, because I'm pouring everything good into my life, bro.
Yeah.
You know, I'm just adding value to myself. I gotta be a man of value, so I'm just pouring in great things into my life, man, watching what I put in my mind, watching what I see, watching what I hear, you know what I'm saying? I'm taking things to the next level, because when that level do come, I'm gonna know how to conduct myself, and I gotta reach another level after I reach that next level I was talking about.
Yo, what's going on, world? It's your boy Doug with my co-host K-Rock.
What's going down?
Y'all, welcome to another edition of the Bigger Dream Podcast. Bro, what's going on with you today, bro?
How
you
am feeling? Blessed.
Yeah.
I'm always blessed, man, and I'm just feeling good, bro.
Why you feeling good?
I don't want to say too much, man, but welcome to feelings always change once you hear that good news. It's not the completion, but you just get to hear the good news. Why do the feelings change?
Bro, because, man, I mean, when you work so hard for something, then you know, it's right there in front of your face. Yeah. You get excited, like that. Yeah, like you can catch it. You can hold on to it. You can see. You can touch it. So yeah.
I guess my emotions changed. You know, I guess when we hear just a little good news. You know what I'm saying, man. So I'm feeling good now. I'm great. You know, no matter. Hey, the other day I wasn't doing too good, but nah, man, I'm good though now, man. But how you feeling, bro?
I'm feeling good, man. Same as you. Feeling great. You know what I'm saying? bro. Man, how you feel about my intro, bro? I was just thinking about that, bro.
Let me take a shot for everybody real quick, man.
How you gonna take a little shot?
Take a shot for y'all, man. This is water, man.
No, I'm talking about like when I be like, it's your boy, dude. You think I should?
I like that.
Okay.
It's you. Yeah.
Yeah. Okay.
I feel like this is going to be big in the future. You know, everybody's going to be waiting for that. It's your boy. Yeah, I like that. What y'all think about the intro, man? Hey, help us out here.
Oh, man. Man, y'all, man, well, bro, how was your week, man? Like, before we hop into it, like, because today, you know, we record on Thursday to drop to you guys on Friday. So, how has your, like, Monday through, like, Wednesday being, I guess?
Man, it went pretty good. You know, again, like I said, I'm just still growing every day, learning how to control frustration, trying to be productive. Could have been more productive than I was this week.
Mm-hmm.
But I'm getting ready for my mom's birthday, man. Shout out to my mama.
Yes,
it's going down Saturday. You know, the whole family going down. I won't put her age out, but we will be celebrating her birthday Saturday. So, yep, man, I actually had a good week.
Mm-hmm.
Been in my words, you know me. You know what I'm saying? Staying in my word. And just, I'm telling you, I'm feeding my mind every single day. I'm talking about the word, positivity, motivational. You know what I'm saying? Like, bro, that's just what I'm on. So, yeah, man, this week it's been a great week. It could have been better. I could have done some things better.
Yeah.
But that's what life is all about. Once you acknowledge those things that you could have did better, you got next week, if the Lord say the same, you got next week, man, and go kill it, and it's corrected.
Mm.
You know what I'm saying? So, yeah, what about your week? How your Monday through Thursday been going?
Yeah,
Thursday was my favorite day, though.
Yeah. But like we always say, bro, each week is a constant battle, you know what I'm saying, to try to get better.
Yeah.
So, you know, I'm going to go back to Sunday. You know, Sunday was Father's Day.
Mm.
Shout out to all the fathers out there.
Yeah, shout out to the fathers.
Me and my mom, we cooked my dad a dinner. You know what I'm saying? I fixed him. Man, I love cooking, bro. I fixed my dad some shrimp, fried and on the stove. I mean, like boiled. I don't even know what you call it. Boiled on the stove type, whatever. And man, the food was fire. I know my pops, he really enjoyed it. And like I told you, man, my dad, he just hit me with some deep stuff. He was just like, man, we just need to start doing more things as a family. Yeah. He was like, he feel like we, like, drifting off like a little bit, and I was like, man, most definitely, like, we definitely need to go do something. So he got a couple ideas that he want to do, me and him, and then we got a couple ideas for the family and everything like that. So, but yeah, Monday through Wednesday, it was really a challenge. And we're gonna get into the topic here in a little bit for me. I was in a state of like pretty much like battling myself, bro, trying to get to the next level, but still getting pushed back, you know, and I was getting frustrated with myself. Like this whole week, bro, like super frustrated. Today has actually been, before we heard the good news, like it's been like the best day for me for like this whole week. So I guess my Thursday has been amazing as well. But y'all, man, I called Ross up. I don't know if he was talking on the phone or he was texting, but I was like, bro, I was like, man, my job getting in the way of my success. Like, and y'all, I really, like when I sent that to Ross, I wasn't like, all right, I want to talk about that on the podcast. I was just, he hit me with something. I don't know. I forgot what we were talking about, but I just came out like, bro, my job is getting in the way of my success. And I don't know if that was like on a Monday or not. But then like throughout this whole week, I was just like, bro, like each day I feel the same way. I'm like, bro, my job is getting in the way. My job is getting in the way. My job is getting in the way. And, you know, I work overnight. So like during the day, I be sleepy. And, you know, most entrepreneurs who, you know, work at night during the day, that's when they supposed to get they work in for their business, you know. And for me, I work at night, then during the day I get up, but then I get real sleepy, like, and I gotta take a nap, then I wake up and I try to do some work, then I get sleepy again, and I nap again, then so it's just been like a constant battle within myself, and I'm like, man, I have to make changes, bro. So man, this week it's been real shaky because of that, because I'm sleepy and this and that. And I know you, and man, I always think about this all the time. I'll be like, bro, and I sent you and cousin Jeremy a message last night. I was like, what'd I say? I said, I'm a grind harder, fellas, or something. Cause I always feel like when I'm not on my A game, when I'm not productive, I'm letting you guys down. Yeah. So I hit y'all with a message last night. I'm just like, bro, pretty much I have to go harder. So I just want to start it off right there, bro. Like for me here this week, man, I truly do feel like my job has been getting in the way of me getting to that next level, bro.
So I feel that, man. You know, I had that same thing happen to me before, you know, but I just really had to just balance things out. You know,
that's what
I had to deal with it. And I think it's a lot of people that's out there that's battling that same issue. You know what I'm saying? You just got to deal with it. You know, you got to find out what works best for you. I'll be telling Doug, I say, Doug, man, you just got to shut it down at 5 o'clock so you get you some rest. Doug swear I get some sleep every day, man.
He
say, man, I run off 8 hours of sleep, man. I probably run off 4 to 5 hours of sleep each day. You know, and if I do take a nap, you know, and this can help someone if you want to take a nap. And you know that you still have to get your business running and things like that. I probably take an hour nap, and it don't even last an hour. I get 30 minutes, then my phone ringing, you know. But I put the alarm on just for an hour, so I just get that power nap in and just reset my mind. Because sometimes when I do I work, you know, off the part-time joint, you know, you do be tired. You know, your mind do need to rest. And you, in your mind, you tell yourself at the job, okay, when I get home, I'm finna do this, that, and that.
Yeah.
When you get home, you're like, okay, hold on, body's saying you need to rest a little bit.
I hate it, bro.
Man, so I'll rest for that hour or 30 minutes, just close my eyes, you know, and then after that, just go after the race, you know, once you wake up and do what you gotta do. So I just wanna encourage whoever else is battling with that same issue, like, man, you just gotta deal with it until you get broke free. And the only way you gonna get set free is when you set yourself free. So you can either, you got two choices to make. You can either grind for your business and that's gonna set you free, or you can set yourself free. You can just walk away from that part-time job and say, hey, I'm betting on myself. This is what I'm going to do. Because I even had to come talk with myself about that. I'm like, hey, you know what? I gave myself a certain month, and I believe I told you the month. I was like, bro, I just gotta walk off. You know, because I truly believe in myself. I truly believe in the business. I believe that we can go to that next level, and I need all my time, you know, for me to do that. And even though I'm only working 4 hours of part-time, I laughed at it. I'm like, it's really not that bad. It's just 4 hours.
Yeah,
like, Ross, you really can do this, bro. You know what I'm saying? So I just want to be so selfish with my time, and I want to control my whole life. So they can't even have the folk. You feel me? So or you can just get, like I said, you can give yourself some time. Write a plan out and say, hey, I'm gonna walk off and I'm set myself free. Like, if you gotta do what's best for you, you know what I'm saying? If you feel like that you truly can make it and you don't need that job or whatever, do what you gotta do, because your dreams waiting on you, they counting on you. And man, you got to do what you do to make it do what it do.
Yeah,
man. I just want to encourage somebody. Cause it's a lot of people battling with that.
Yeah.
It's a lot of people battling with it, and you got to truly just deal with it. You got to look it in his face, like, okay, this is what I'm doing, and you got to get on the scales. You know, I'm doing it at night, joint. 6 things you have to do.
Yeah, you know? So, I ain't did that in a minute.
That's just what you got to do, man. You got to deal with it.
Yeah, and bro, you're right. You said a lot of people, you know, are going through this. A lot of people, you know, out there, they're putting their whole life on hold, you know, for this job. They putting their dreams on hold, you know, for this job. And I said, I can't be like that. Because, you know, every day when I go into work and I come back and I work or whatever, and then I take a nap, I be like, man, I just lost. And I said, bro, I can't go years with this keep happening. I can't keep being like, oh man, I'm sleepy, let me nap.
Yeah.
Every single day for like years and years to come. And I was just thinking about like how, pretty much what you just said, bro. The people who let that happen on a cycle for years, and then 5 years, 10 years, 15, and then pretty much that time period for them to, when they were supposed to succeed or grow in their business or whatever, like it just passed them by. So I said, man, I refuse. I refuse for that to be me, because I see this with, you know, different people, different people that's older than me. And I'm like, man, like I don't want to be like that.
Yeah.
So I said, I have to make some changes. Like you said, I have to make it do what it do. So I now adjusted a few things in my life, and I'm, the luxury of my job is so flexible that I can pick my own schedule, you know? So I said, man, I'm finna just stop going as hard. And then on the days when I don't go in, I'ma just, you know, that's when I'ma put more time in on the business. But for the people who don't have that flexibility, that's when you gonna have to put in the
extra. You got to.
You like, you really have no choice, or you have to go with Ross. 100%. Said, pretty much what me and Ross did, jump off the job. You know, you have to jump off in order to take things to the next level. And people, they may be scared because they're like, okay, if I jump off the job, it may set me back. In reality, okay, you may not get that, well, you're not gonna receive that paycheck weekly or every other week, but you're gonna be putting more time into your baby. You're gonna be putting more time into this business that you see for yourself that's gonna grow. And you know, like I was telling Ross, I had a conversation with an individual a couple weeks ago, and they got their own business, and I mean, I feel like they killing it. The numbers that they tell me that they be receiving, I said, hey, you are killing it. And that person, they still have a corporate job. And, you know, somebody close to them said, hey, how much money do I need to pay you for you to quit your job and just chase your dreams? And I told Ross that, and I said, what if somebody told us that? How much money do I have to pay you to quit?
That was like a disappear right now.
How much money could we pay y'all to quit y'all job and just chase your dreams? I said, to me, that felt like a no-brainer. Like, oh, I mean, I give them an amount if they serious. And I'm, like you said, deuces.
Yeah.
But I don't understand how a person don't see that and be like, dang, like, hey, this the like, what's a better opportunity than that? And the person that I was talking to was like, yeah, they not asked me this a couple times. So I'm like, if a person have their business or whatever, they got their dreams and all this, why are they putting it on hold for a job? And I mean, I understand, you know, that security blanket, but I feel like the way society is and how everything, like, we've been molded into feeling like we need this security with everything we go through. And, you know, me and Ross, we not figured out that, hey, we necessarily don't need that security blanket. Nah. Like, we gonna bet on ourselves. Yeah. And I just want you guys out there to bet on yourself. If there's something that you want to do, there's a dream, there's a goal that you want to chase, that you want to accomplish, don't be those people that when you get older, you be like, I should have did this. I wish that I would have done this. Because, you know, me, I'm not gonna, I made it, I promised myself that that was not gonna be me. So I just, man, here recently, man, I'm just going harder, bro. And today, I got up before my alarm, and I said, man, I have to make this change. So today's been like my best day. Then we heard some great news, and I'm like, man, that's just a plus on top of a plus.
Like, hold on, do you need to wake up earlier now? Like, is that,
I don't know, man.
Is that the code? Is that the cheat code?
Maybe, bro. Instead of sleeping in, I need to just wake up before the alarm joint. But, Ross said this a while back. He was just like, people got their gifts on hold. And then I was just thinking this week, I said, bro, forget the gift. People put their whole life on hold, bro. And I'm not going to be that person at all, bro. So I just encourage you guys, man, please go out there and chase your dream, because there's other people out there chasing their dreams, and they don't care about no security blanket, none of that. And you can see the success that they're having within their business, within whatever they're doing, man. Mm-hmm. So, man, I just feel like, bro, right now, man, I feel like transitioning, bro, because I always tell you guys, me and my other cousin, my business partners, mm-hmm. Let's take this thing to the next level. You will say something, I'll be, all right, bro, let's do it. Let's do it, whatever. Because I'm like, man, we really need to take things to the next level. And I know things aren't going to happen unless we do something, right, bro. So if I don't do what I need to do, I feel like, I know y'all guys going to be doing what y'all doing. But I always feel like, Brandon, Doug, if you're not doing what you need to do, it's not going to work. Yeah. And I would hate for you guys to do all the work. And I'm just over here in this little slump. I'm getting beat up by my job each week. And I'm like, bro, I don't want to be like that, bro. So that's why I always tell y'all, bro, like, for real, like, I'm going to go harder. And when I say that, in my mind, I really be meaning that, bro. Yeah. But then after work, life having work, job, I be like, bro, and then I just get dropped, bro. Yeah. So, man, that's what I battle with.
You just got to keep swinging. That's the thing, bro. I told y'all about this before, man. Again, King David in the Bible. When I look at his life, my brother, first of all, he was a warrior. He was a king.
Okay.
And he went to battle with his troops, you know. And you just can't tell me that David didn't go to war and didn't get cut sometime. You know, you can't just tell me. Because back then, you know, there wasn't no shooting going on. They had swords. So you can't tell me that they didn't get cut. He didn't get hit one time, you know. But he fought back. My brother, my boy killed 10,000 heads. You know, he killing boys, you know. So I put my life in that same situation. I'm like, when I feel like life is beating me up, I gotta fight back, you know. And then, again, this past week, I'm getting way better to dealing with frustration. You know, I just tell myself, it's not what it seems. It just looked like this. And we talked about that seeing boy in the faith. You know, you can't go by what it looked. You know, they not answering the phone. You can't go off what you see. You just got to truly believe, hey, I'm trusting in this process, and I don't want to touch on this no more, but I'm trusting in the process. This is what's going to take me to that number one spot, to where I want to be at. So, man, you just got to fight back, man, and just not go off what you see. You just got to fight back, but hey, I'm going to do it. If I say that I'm going to go do it, I'm going to open up a computer, I'm going to look up this, I'm going to do that, I'm going to reach out to this property, I'm going to reach out to this person, you know what I'm saying? Whatever it may be. Fight back. Like, do what you say you're going to do, man. So that's what I've been working on, bro. But, I had a day like, man, I got beat up. I think it was Tuesday. I'm like, man, you know what? I didn't stay up here. Went to sleep, you know, and I don't know why. You know, I don't know why we go through that as humans, you know, but we got to learn how to fight back, you know. So I feel like that's the best thing to do.
So, like, what do we do, bro? Like, so what are some things that you do? Like, I know, for example, one thing, and you know, and I'm talking about now to like get to that next level. You told me, you said, bro, you cut off the subscription on the game or something like that?
Oh, yeah, I don't even play the game no more. And I ain't gonna lie to you, I listened to my boy E, you know what I'm saying? Shout out to E. The man was like, bro, you know, it's like 300 some people that's trying to do what you do. What is you doing on the game? I was like, you right, E. You know what I'm saying? Like, I gotta take things now. I gotta take things to the next level, you know what I'm saying? And the next level is my mindset, you know, my habits, you know, things that I do, again, like behind closed doors, like those taking things to my relationships, like that's taking things to the next level, you know, and especially in our business, like that's what's going to add on to that next level. So, man, yeah, bro, that's what I had to do. I cut the game. I don't even play the game no more.
Dang, bro.
You know what I'm saying? I'll tell you, I barely even listen to rap. If I listen to rap, I don't even... Cause I'm pouring everything good into my life, bro.
Yeah.
You know, I'm just adding value to myself. I gotta be a man of value. So I'm just pouring in great things into my life, man. Watching what I put in my mind, watching what I see, watching what I hear. You know what I'm saying? I'm taking things to the next level. Cause when that level do come, I'm gonna know how to conduct myself, and I gotta reach another level after I reach that next level. That's I was talking about.
Yeah.
You know, and once the level come, I know where to go. I know exactly where to go. I'm reading the right books. You know what I'm saying? I'm getting the right information. When it's time, once we reach that next level, I'm applying what I have learned on that level to get to that further level than what I was trying to get to. So, yeah.
Yeah, and we were talking about before the podcast about pretty much like leveling up and being busy. But you said it ain't really even going to feel like it. But I'm like, I feel like within our lives, bro, like, we gonna reach this certain level, like you pretty much just said, yeah. Then it's another level that we chasing.
Oh,
so it's gonna be like nonstop, like different levels, whether that's, you know, relationally, you know, in business, just whatever, man. So, man, I feel like, bro, it's a, what you be calling, like a healthy challenge? Is that what you call it?
Yeah, it's gonna be a healthy challenge. Again, like, man, once we get to that first level, and I believe the first level is putting your own mask on. I tell Doug all this time, we gotta take care of ourselves, put ourselves in position so we can help others. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
I feel like that's gonna be the best part. Like, once we get to that part, once we get to that level where we can help others, it's not gonna be busy, it's gonna be fun. You know what I'm saying? Like, you're gonna have a good feeling just to be able to give.
Yeah.
Not even monetary wise, like information, like how we give on The Bigger Dream. Mm-hmm. We love to do this. Like, we don't care about, like, we laugh at other podcasts because we like, this is what the world wanted to see, you know. We wanted, if we showed y'all the Ciroc and stuff, of course, you know, people tuning in, but we love positivity, we love to live righteous. We're trying our best to live righteous. Okay, yeah, we mess up sometimes, but we're gonna correct it.
Thanks.
You know what I'm saying? But I believe it's gonna be fun, not in the sense of busy. We're gonna be like, I mean, we're gonna be busy, but we're gonna have fun though, you know what I'm saying? Like, life is gonna be way better than what it is
now.
Nah,
for real, bro.
And the process is just teaching us so many things. That's all it is. So, yeah.
Yeah, and, you know, like you said, helping people out. Like, I know on a daily, even when we at work, we helping folks out.
Oh, yeah, I'd be pissed.
Bro, you got to explain it. So, you be pissed, you say you still going to do it.
Oh, yeah, for sure.
Because, like, I be, and me and Ross, we both figured out, you know, y'all in this side, our previous podcast, we took the assessment. We both S's. We're both hot S's.
And what we do.
If y'all want the link, hey, we might see.
Nah, they're not going to get the link. We got to pay. We got to pay for that link, man. I'm not paying for that link.
we always joke about, like, how when we at work or whatever, like, we knock out our task or whatever, and then we see somebody else need some help, we'll stop. Well, I don't know. Sometimes I stop what I'm doing. I just hear up and boom, boom, help somebody else out, and then come back to me. But that's just my personality. And folks be messing with me at work. They be like, oh, you always doing, or you always helping out, or you say you're going to leave at this time, but you end up staying. I'm like, when I tell you that I want to leave, I really do be wanting to leave at this time. But something, every time when I know that a task ain't done, I see somebody needing help, it's just in me to go help out this person. And like Ross was saying, when we do get to that next level, like right now, it's not even monetary, and we're going to keep it that way, even though we are going to be helping folks out monetary-wise, and we got different ways we're going to help people out because we talk about it so much. But we're going to enjoy doing that as well, and we already love doing it, man. So it's really not going to be big. It's just going to be, like you said, bro, pretty much just like fun things to do, and we're going to have a great feeling because I get a great feeling when, you know, I'm giving and enjoying things like that, bro. So, man, I agree with you 100%. But, bro, another thing, man, before we do end everything, bro, I was just thinking, because, you know, every time we have a topic, it don't necessarily always have to be business. And I always try to throw, like, relationship type stuff in there. But, man, I was just thinking, bro, like, how many people let their jobs get in the way of their relationship, though? You know, like, and I know, and I want you to talk on this as well, bro, but I know beforehand, and I think I spoke about this on the podcast before, I was always business. When we first started our business, y'all,
bro,
even when I had a girl, I was business. And I remember one time I broke up. Well, me and my ex broke up.
Yeah.
And then she was like, I forgot everything she said, bro, but she was just like, I hope something with you go with you or whatever. And then she was like, but I already know, only thing you're going to be worried about is your business. And as long as your business is good. And at that time, I was like, yeah, I'm make sure my business is good.
Yeah.
But I realized that I'm giving my business 100%. I'm giving my girl 50%.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? And it shouldn't be that way.
Nah.
Like, at all, man. Like, I want to give everything that I do 100%. And, you know, people who got, you know, jobs or businesses and things like that, like, you guys have to really create that balance, you know, where you're giving your business this, or you got a certain time to work on your business, then after what's 8 o'clock, 9 o'clock, or whatever, that's when you supposed to leave the business alone and go watch a movie with your bride, you know what I'm saying, with your girl
with
or whatever, and just spend time with her, or just delegate, you know, different time for different activities in your life, man. So I don't know why when I was younger, I didn't think like that. Because I really thought that I was doing the right thing. I said, man, I have to give everything and my all to the business. But I realized, like, man, you want your girl on your side to be right there, and you want to treat everything that you do 100%, man. Yeah. So y'all just out there with the job, and, you know, you go home to your man or to your woman, and, you know, you just so stressed out about the job, and everything you talk about is the job when you with your significant other. Man, you really might have to change that, man, because that job is getting it's tough because, you know,
I can't stop thinking about it still to this day.
That's what I'm finna say. Like, we always be thinking about it, but I know you don't just neglect your girl for the business, bro.
Nah, I don't neglect her, but I do go through my moments where, because the goal is not, I haven't reached the goal yet, you know, and I be so focused on the business that I don't give my girl 100%, you know, and like you said, that's wrong of me. You know, I supposed to be 100% that area because that's important.
Yeah.
You know, yeah, the business is important, but my relationship, I don't know how much time left I'm going to have with my baby. You know what I'm saying? And I do want to get married one day.
Yeah.
You feel me? So this is important. You know what I'm saying? So I do need to be like, okay, hey, business is over with. Let me give my girl what she want, what she needs. You know what I'm saying? And I need to be 100% in that area. But it be times when I just be like, ah, I got a lot of things going racing in my mind. So that's another moment that I have to have a pause in my life and be like, hey, let's push this back. And my mind said, let's give my woman what she needs. So yeah, I fall victim of it too, bro. Like, I fall short in that area too. And that's something that I have to grow in. I thank you for bringing that out.
Yeah, but I do, you know, like the fact that, you know, based on what you tell me and stuff like that, when you do see yourself mess up, and y'all, this is very important, this is key.
Yeah.
Like, you ask for forgiveness and, you know, whatever you mess up in, and you actually acknowledge, you know, that you messed up. Like, hey, babe, I didn't give you 100% today because I was working or whatever with the business. I'm sorry. Boom, boom, boom. Cause I know not everybody, they gonna apologize for them messing up. They just gonna be like, oh, I did it. All right.
Man, listen, bro, like 2 weeks ago, I had yelled at my girl for no reason. I said, girl, we need to come on and go. Just yelled at her. And I went outside. I said, Dad, that wasn't right of you to yell at your woman. She did. You know what I'm saying? And I apologized to her. I said, forgive me for yelling at you.
Not for real.
You know what I'm saying? Even though you are slow, forgive me for yelling at you. You know what I'm saying? Because that wasn't right. Because we need to. Us men, we need to act as men, you know what I'm saying? Be gentle and kind to our women, you know what I'm saying? We just don't talk to them any kind of way. We're supposed to love a person, and let's not love a person how we think we should love one another. Let's love them how God say love a person, you know what I'm saying? And I always send her 1 Corinthians, you know what I'm saying? Just to let us both know, like, hey, this is how we're supposed to love each other.
So that's love in the Bible?
Yeah, when 1 Corinthians, I forgot the verses. But it say love is kind, it's patient, you know, it's kind, you know what I'm saying? And it goes in deeper about, I'm paraphrasing, it goes in deeper about love. So if we love like how God say love each other, we'll be 100%. We start loving how we think we supposed to love each other, we at 50, 30, 20%, you know what I'm saying? So yeah, that's what we need to do. So I had to ask her for forgiveness, you know, hey, man, I'm sorry for yelling at you. You know what I'm saying? It was that little small thing, but that's big though.
Yeah. That it, like you said, it's small,
but it's big.
But it's big because not a lot of people do that, man. I know that that's an important thing to do, bro. When we get done with this podcast, I need to look at that mud though, for real.
Oh, okay.
First Corinthian joint. But bro, I be catching myself doing the same thing, like going back and talking to myself.
Oh yeah.
I be like, bro, duh, man, you should never do it there, bro. I be saying that all the time to myself, bro. That's crazy. Like, yeah, I really be having, like, a battle within my head. Because I be, like the other day, I went to the restroom at work. And, you know, I washed my hands, boom, boom. And I had dried them off with a paper towel. And I walked out and I threw the napkin at the trash can. That mud laid on the floor.
I would have kept going. Hey. Missed the shot. Oh, wait.
Bro, you stupid.
Hey, I ain't gonna lie to you. I'm just glad you washed your hands. Your boy, ever since these shots going around, folks ain't washing hands no more. I'm walking in. I'm like, bro, what you? I I'm like, bro, you tripping, bro. COVID still here, bro.
Nah, for real.
Man, they so comfortable. Oh, I'm vaccinated. I ain't got to wash my hands no more. I'm, bro, you tripping.
Nasty.
I'm going to start confronting folks on that, though, bro. Hey, bro, wash your hands again, bro.
Again?
Yeah, hey, nah, I mean, he ain't even washing. I'm just saying again. Like, you started off when COVID first hit, oh, you know, okay, washing hands. You know what I'm saying? Start back washing hands. Nothing. Here goes some hand sanitizer. But oh, yeah, go back to your story, my bad, bro. I'm sorry. Bro, I just had to put that in there, bro.
I had a battle with myself because I'm that type of person that if I, I'm a pick it up, put it trash.
Yeah, I know you are, real tough.
Yeah, trash 100%. Car. Yeah. I mean, car
you center. Had, you brought conviction in my heart. You done popped up in my mind. I said, man, let me go ahead. Now I just go do it. Man, let me go pick this
up. That's what I'm talking about. But man, yeah, I threw the paper towel trash, that mud. Obviously, it didn't go in. I went, picked it up, threw it in the trash can. But it was two napkins, so I picked one up, threw it, I walked off. I looked back, bro. I said, it's still another one on it. I said, man. So I went back and did it, bro. In my head, bro, someone was telling me, bro, just walk off. Yeah. Ain't no, did
good,
no, nobody seen it. Nobody, you know, seen it.
Look, I'm so spiritual. I'm like, man, it's a sin. I'm like, man, I didn't see it, bro. Let me go pick that. Nah, I'm just playing. That's a Christian joke, man. But yeah.
But yeah, I went back and I just put both of them in the other one inside the trash, man. Yeah. But I be having battles with myself all the time about doing the right thing, right, because I truly value doing the right thing, that's in my right life, even when nobody's looking, y'all. And man, that's very, very important, man. So yeah, bro, just always that battle with myself. And just one more point, I want to kind of backtrack a little bit when you were talking about the game. A thought popped up in my mind, and I was just like, you know, sometimes, like, I be getting text messages or whatever. My bro would be like, hey, bro, first thing in the morning, hey, bro, hop on the game, bro.
Oh, yeah.
I said, in my head, I'm thinking, I said, bro, I am a grown 25-year-old. Yeah. What do I look like first thing in the morning, waking up, getting on the game?
No.
I said, bro,
we got things to do, my man.
Yeah, grind. I got to grind for the business, man. So I was just thinking, like, that's some stuff back in the day when I used to wake up, be on the game.
Yeah.
I'm talking about first thing.
First thing.
2K, well, Call of Duty, all that good stuff.
I'm taking the shot, playing the game.
Oh, yeah.
I ain't lying to you.
But at that time, we didn't really,
we had no purpose in life. We were just living, you know. Mm. We didn't fall into the purpose life.
Yeah,
when we fell into the purpose life, it was on and popping.
Yeah, because it's like we always got something to do. Right. It's like we have to accomplish this.
I only got 24 hours. I got to do what I got to do this today.
Yeah,
you know, I can't play the game, which I'm sorry.
Yeah,
you know,
yeah,
you play that game because I'm telling you, when you see me when I'm 30 years old, the way I'm living like this, and I ain't talking about monetary, right? I'm talking about controlling my life.
Mm-hmm.
You gonna see why I didn't play that game early that morning. You gonna see why.
Yeah,
and then you gonna be asking questions. I'm gonna tell you, you better stop playing that game. You feel me? You better get on it.
Yeah.
Cause your process waiting on you. If you want to come live this life, the process waiting on you. You got to go through it though. Dang. But the blessing is you got me on your team. You got me on your squad.
They don't understand that though.
I can help you doing the hard areas. I didn't have that. Me and Doug, we don't have that, not during our process.
Yeah.
It's just us. We don't have a mentor. Like, you know what I'm saying? So we have to be the mentees. We have to be those for them. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. So, yeah. So that's the blessing part of it.
Nah, I agree with you 100%, man. And it's a quote, bro, that I seen this quote. I kind of forgot. I really forgot that much, but it was pretty much saying what you were saying as far as, you know, you said when you turn 30, you gonna see.
Oh, yeah.
Like,
why I did that? Why I started 26, 27
years old. Man, I forgot the quote, bro. But that's so important. Like, I think it was like, y'all can have y'all fun. Something like, y'all can have y'all fun. Now I'm gonna have my fun. It was something, man. Yeah. But folks really, and I understand, bro. It's hard. Like, the process is hard. It's hard not to get on the game. Hard not to go out, spend money. Is hard.
It's challenging.
Yeah, that's what it is. That's what it is.
Yeah.
It's challenging. And I feel like now for us, since we got so accustomed to not doing a lot of those things, it's easy now.
Yeah.
And I ain't gonna say we necessarily look at the people that do it and be like, you know, but like I see them and I be like, bro, like I feel like, and I really can't judge nobody, but I be like, man, you probably wasting time, man, because like I said, man, I study the millionaires, and bro, they be having the blueprint. Bro, people just talk about, they tell you the keys, they tell you how to get to the next level. And you know, we always talk about that process and things like that. And every time they talk about the process, it be the same stuff we going through.
No, real tough.
It be the same. And I be like, bro, we really on the right track,
bro. Right track. This is what it takes.
This is all that it takes. And I don't really want to go too much on the trust your process concept. But it's like, y'all, it's going to hurt. It's going to be tough. It's not going to go as planned.
Real tough.
But you just got to keep going, man. And
seriously,
I feel like, bro.
And it's so cliche, you just said keep going. It's something that you really got to do, though.
Nah, for real,
like,
bro.
Real talk. You got to make up in your mind. I'll tell you, I made my mind. It's the death. I'm dying for this.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? I wouldn't live my life no other way.
Nah,
I'm not giving my life to corporate no more. Hey, no, I'm telling you, I'm not against corporate America. That's what you want to do. That's what you want to do. I'm talking about me, my life. You feel me? So, hey, I'm going to be an entrepreneur. I'm going to take over my life.
Mm-hmm.
I'm going to control my life. And I'm going to be a blessing not only to my family, to my church family, to people I never met in my life, and I'm going to win a million souls while doing it.
Facts.
And I'm going to do it here on the Bigger Dream Podcast.
Yeah.
So that's what entrepreneurship, that's what it brings to you. Because at first, we didn't have this mindset. You know, I remember with me and Doug, and I'm not going to go too deep because I know we got time, you know.
Yeah.
But I just remember when we first started out, we wasn't like this, man. I remember we were going to the office and just sitting there. You know, we would talk for hours. You know, we were just growing then. That's when growth started. And then we just really got into the process. I mean, I'll tell you, we blew the whole 2018. We blew it on talking. You know, we didn't really put no action in it, you know what I'm saying? But 2019, that's when we really started getting out there.
Bro, I think 2018, we focused really on, like, being seen and letting everybody know that we got a business.
Yeah.
Hey, we got a business.
Yeah.
But then we realized, hey.
We ain't got no business.
We ain't got no money.
We ain't got no money. We ain't got no business. We just got a business and we paying taxes. You know what I'm saying? And when tax time come around, you know what I'm saying? Boys coming out of pocket.
Yeah. So
we need to get some business so we can pay for these taxes.
So I think that's why we got more serious like the second year. Yeah. And then from there, y'all just been up from there, man.
Yeah,
so y'all, shout out to the process. Shout out to whatever process you guys are going through.
I need a shirt.
What?
Shout out to the process. You did something on that one, Doug.
You not did something on that one.
Nah, we gonna get the shirt. Hey, shout out to the process.
Shout
we probably had to sell that here on the Bigger Dream Podcast.
Oh my goodness, that's a good one.
I like that one.
Shout out to the process, y'all. Yeah, man. So y'all, I really hope y'all took something from this podcast today, man. Please do not let, if you got a business, you got a side hustle you're pursuing, you have on the side, do not let your job get in the way of your success. Like Ross said, it will be challenging.
Yeah.
Y'all, it will be challenging, but you have to fight. Wake up and fight every single day. I was getting beat up at the beginning of the week, but I had to just make up in my mind, like, am I going to live the rest of my life just getting beat up? You know what I'm saying? Or am I going to actually, like Ross said, just swing back, swing harder every single day? So I just made up my mind. And today was a great start for me, man. And I plan on, you know, continue to doing this, y'all. So put a plan in action. Also, if you have a significant other and you letting work get in the way of y'all success, man, put a plan together, figure out what you need to do, what time you're supposed to dedicate to work, and probably just while you're at work, and then when you get home, you know, spend time with your other, and just enjoy that time together, and just give them 100%, man, because I guarantee once you give that person 100%, man, bro, it's going to be the best feeling ever. And it's going to be good from you because you giving somebody 100% and you giving them your all, man. So I feel like that's what it's all about. Y'all, before we get out of here, y'all, shout out to the...
I do want to encourage my entrepreneurs right now. This is for you all. It's still second quarter. It's no time to be giving up. I know it's been tough, like Doug say. I know that you're hurting. I know you be getting beat up, but it's no time to be giving up. This is a very important quarter. It's almost over with. Third quarter is coming up. You know what I'm saying? Halftime, you only get 2 minute break. You know what I'm saying? So third quarter is coming up. It's gonna be go time for a lot of companies out here, for a lot of entrepreneurs. This is where your contracts will be coming in. Fourth quarter, your contracts will be coming in. You feel me? So let's go hard. You had a great first quarter. You fought hard in the second quarter. It's time to put up them shots in the third and fourth quarter, and let's end this year off strong, man. Let's do this. You got what it takes. You truly, truly got what it takes to go to the next level. You're going to see me and Doug rise to the next level. And again, once we put our mask on, we're reaching down to bring people back up.
Facts. Yeah, we always going to have that in us, reach back down.
Yeah, you know? Reach back down. They're not going to catch that, but we're going to reach back down and we're going to help y'all, man, for sure.
Yeah, y'all, shout out to the sponsor, Love Waste Management, the best trash valet vendor here in the Dallas-Fort Worth area. If you stay in any apartments and they have a trash valet service and they're not doing a good job, notify the front office. Complain to the front office about this. Let them know that you know of a better trash valet vendor, Love Waste Management. Here in the Triple D, man, go to their website, lovewastemgmt.com, Instagram, Love Waste Management. Y'all, so like I said, I hope y'all enjoyed it. We're going to drop this tomorrow on Friday for you guys. And shoot, man, we out of here. All right.